show you our linear IC trainer kit. Order code is 36101. So this is the IC trainer kit. This is analog voltmeter built on the panel. There are three range, 100 millivolt, 1 volt and 40 volt. With the help of this switch, we can select the range. This is an inbuilt LED to show the output status. This is an inbuilt current meter, analog current meter. There is also three range. This is, one is 50 milliampere, 250 milliampere and 500 milliampere. With the help of this knob, we can select the ranges. Here on the panel, there are different types of ICs. This is 710, this is 741, there are two 741 ICs, there are two 3130 ICs, there are 723, 566, 565 and 555, and there are two voltage regulators 7812 and 7912. These are the different types of capacitor, diode, resistor, zener diode, and these are the potentiometer of 1 kilowatt, 4K7, 10K, 47K, 100K. These are two switch on the panel. This is 0 to 30 volt DC regulative variable power supply at 500 milliampere, and this is fixed for power supply plus minus 12 volt DC at 250 milliampere. This is also fixed DC power supply plus minus 6 volt DC at 200 milliampere. This is the main switch to turn on or off the kit, and this is the fuse 200 milliampere. There is a square wave generator, 1 kilohertz square wave generator, also a 100 hertz sine wave generator. This is the pulsar block. With the help of this, we can give pulse input. There are two transistor here. This is the user manual. Patch cords and manual are included with this kit, and to perform the experiments, we will need a audio frequency generator and a CRO to observe the waveform. Experiment is to measure the quiescent supply current of op amp. To perform the experiment, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So for this, we will need IC741. So first, short these two terminal 2 and 3. Short these two terminal and then ground the terminal. Now we will give power supply to terminal 7. The positive power supply will go to terminal 7 and negative power supply will go to terminal 4. So I am connecting terminal 4 with minus 12 volt DC and connect this in series with the ammeter, and we will connect the positive terminal of the ammeter with plus 12 volt DC. Now we will turn on the kit and we will see that there will be around 1 milliampere current. The current will be vary as this is a 50 milliampere range. So as I am turning the kit, we can see there is 1 milliampere current. This is the quiescent supply current and flows due to the biasing of internal circuit of IC. Our next experiment is to null the offset voltage. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So first, connect terminal 2 with the 1K resistor and with the help of this resistor we will ground this terminal. Now connect terminal 3 with a 1k resistor also, and also with the help of this 1k resistor we will ground this terminal also. So connect this, and after that we will also ground this. Now from terminal 2 connect a 10k resistor and connect it at terminal 6. This is the feedback. Now connect terminal 1 with a 10k potentiometer . Connect the another end of this potentiometer with terminal 5 and connect a negative power supply minus 12 volt to the middle terminal of the potentiometer. Now connect terminal 4 with the negative power supply . Now we will give positive power supply to terminal 7. After that we will observe the output voltage at terminal 6. Connect this with ground terminal. Now turn on the kit and we will observe that output voltage will be 0. So select the minimum range, that is 100 millivolt, turn on the key and we can see that the output current is 0. If the output voltage is 0, if it is not 0, then adjust this 10k potentiometer so that it become 0. Now nulling is done and the op amp has no offset now. Our next experiment is to measure the unity gain bandwidth. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So first, we will connect terminal 3 with ground. We give power supply to terminal 7, positive power supply to terminal 7 and negative power supply to terminal 4. Connect terminal 2 with a 10k resistor and connect this 10k resistor to the output, that is terminal 6. Now from terminal 2 we will connect a 1k resistor, and from there we will connect audio frequency generator to give input signal. So we will give input signal here and we will observe the output in CRO. At terminal V0. So keep the level of the out signal around 200 millivolt. Now turn on the kit and we will observe the output current here in the CRO. We will see that the output voltage level of the signal is equal to the input voltage level of the signal. So note down the frequency at which this happens. This is the unity gain bandwidth. Experiment is to measure the rated output. For this, we are going to build this connection here. So first, connect terminal 2 with a 100E resistor and from here Now we will connect the audio frequency generator here at this resistor. Connect the ground terminal of the audio frequency generator here. Now connect terminal 3 with ground. We'll give positive power supply to terminal 7 and negative power supply to terminal 4. From terminal 2, we will connect a 10K resistor to give feedback. Connect this to the output terminal, that is terminal 6. And from terminal 6, we will connect the load resistor 10K. Connect the other terminal to ground. Now we will observe the output waveform at terminal 6 across the, or you can check this across the load resistor also. Connect this to ground. We'll check the output waveform here. Set the input signal frequency at 1 kHz. Now turn on the key. This is the output signal. Now slowly increase the level of the input signal. Slowly increase the level of input signal till the waveform gets distorted. We can see that slowly the waveform is starting to get distorted. Note down the frequency at which the output begins to get distorted. sorry, note down the voltage at which the signal started to get distorted. This is the this voltage. The rated output is less than this voltage. Our next experiment is to measure open loop voltage gain under closed loop condition. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So first, we are going to connect the power supply. So connect terminal 7 with 12 volt power supply, positive 12 volt power supply, and connect terminal 4 with negative power supply. Now, connect terminal 2 with a 1K resistor and we will ground this. Similarly, connect terminal 3 to ground. Now, from terminal 6, connect a 47K resistor . After that, connect this terminal of the resistor with a 100K resistor . Connect this terminal with terminal 2 . Now from this terminal of the 100K resistor, that is the junction between 100K and 47K, connect another 47K resistor. And from this terminal of the resistor, we will connect a 10 hertz sine wave. Also, I am connecting this here. Now, connect the ground with a 1K resistor. From terminal 2, connect a capacitor 470 picofarad and the other end of this capacitor will be connected with a 47K resistor, that is connected with the sine wave generator. So connect this here like this. Now we will observe first the input voltage in the voltmeter. So connect the positive terminal of the voltmeter to terminal 2. And connect the negative terminal to ground. Now turn on the key. This is the input voltage. Now we will observe the output voltage, terminal 6 turn on the key. This is the output voltage VO. From this you can calculate the open loop gain of op amp. This is the formula. This is the open loop gain of op amp A0 equals to minus V0 by VI, where VI is the input voltage which we have observed across terminal 2 and ground. Our next experiment is application of IC3130 as high input impedance voltage follower. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So first, connect terminal 3 with 10K . From here we will give the input. So connect this with an input DC voltage. So I am giving 6 DC voltage. Now connect terminal 7 with positive power supply, and from terminal 7 we'll connect a capacitor. And connect this capacitor to ground. Now, from terminal 2, connect a resistor 2K2. And from this, connect this to terminal 6. Now connect another capacitor across this resistor. We will connect 0.1 microfarad capacitor. Now from terminal 8 we will connect a capacitor 56 picofarad. From 56 picofarad, this terminal, it will connect it with terminal 1. From terminal 1, we will connect a 100K potentiometer. And this terminal, the third terminal of the potentiometer, will be connected to terminal 5. Now connect terminal 4 with the middle terminal of potentiometer. Also from terminal 4 we will ground this. Now connect the voltmeter terminal 6 to observe the output voltage. We will see in this experiment that the output voltage will follow the input voltage. So as we have given plus 6 input voltage, turn on the key and we can see the output voltage is approximately 6. The next experiment is to measure open loop voltage gain of IC710 under closed loop condition. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So first, we will take this IC here 710. So first we are going to connect terminal 11 with positive power supply and terminal 6 with negative power supply, that is minus 6 volt. Now we will connect terminal 4 with ground with the help of a 1K resistor. will short terminal 3 and 2 and we will ground this connection. Now we will connect the sine wave generator with a 47k resistor . Connect this 47k resistor with a 100k resistor and we will connect this to terminal 4. Now from this junction 47k resistor and 100k resistor we will connect another connection. We connect another 47k resistor and we will connect this to terminal 9. This is our output terminal. Now from the 47k resistor that is connected with the sine wave generator, we will connect a 470 picofarad capacitor with to terminal 4. Now first we will observe the input voltage across terminal 4 and 3 and after that we will observe the output voltage VO and across terminal 9, and with the help of a formula that is A0 equals to V0 by VI we will find out the gain under closed loop condition. So first connect this positive terminal to terminal 4 and the negative terminal of the voltmeter to ground, or you can connect it to terminal 3, turn on the kit, select this to minimum range, turn on the kit and note down the input current that is VI. Now change this, connect these two output terminals. This will be our V0. So this is the output current. From this we can calculate the gain, that is A0 equals to minus V0 by VI. Our next experiment is application of IC555 as pulse width modulator. For this we are going to build this connection here. So first we will short these two terminals 4 and 8 and we will connect power supply plus 12 volt. After that, from terminal 4, we will connect a resistor 3.9 to terminal 7. Terminal 7, we will connect terminal 6, and from terminal 6, connect a capacitor 0.01 microfarad. And connect the other terminal of the capacitor to ground. Now, from terminal 2, we will connect another 0.01 capacitor. With the help of this capacitor, we will give clock input to terminal 2. So, connect this end of the terminal to a modulating signal that is 1 kHz square wave. Now, ground terminal 1. From terminal 5, connect a capacitor plus 10 microfarad and connect the other end of the capacitor to ground. Now from point terminal 8, connect a load resistor 1K and connect this to output terminal 3. Now from terminal 5 to terminal 5 we will give a modulating signal. So with the help of this 10 microfarad capacitor, so from this terminal we will connect this sine wave generator. Now we will observe the modulating output across terminal 3 and ground. Turn on the kit. This is the modulated output waveform. Experiment is application as 3 to 23 volt variable output voltage regulator using CA3085. So this is the circuit diagram that we are going to build. So first we are going to short this two terminal 2 and 3, and then we are going to give DC power supply to this connection. So first short 2 and 3, and after that we will give DC power supply 0 to 30 volt variable DC power supply to this junction. Now from 1 we will connect our resistor 5.6 ohm and we will connect it to the output terminal 8. Now we will connect this terminal 4 to the ground. From terminal 7, we will connect a capacitor 1 kPf and we will connect the other terminal of this capacitor to terminal 6 of the IC. Now from 6, we will connect this middle terminal of 10K potentiometer. Using this potentiometer, we will vary the voltage from 3 to 23 volt. Now from terminal 8, connect a 15K resistor After that, from 15K resistor, connect this terminal of the potentiometer, 10K potentiometer. We will connect this last terminal of the 10K potentiometer with a 1 kilo resistor and connect this to the ground. Now connect a voltmeter across terminal 8, connect the positive terminal to terminal 8 and connect the negative terminal to this 1K resistor, that is the terminal that is connected to the ground, or you can directly connect it to the ground. Now we will turn on the kit and we will see that the voltage will be variable between 3 to 23 volt. I am turning on the kit, and with the help of this potentiometer we can regulate the voltage between 3 to 23 volt. So this is almost 23, you can see here this is 24, almost 23, and this is 3.